childhood friend. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Welcome in, guys. Thank you so much for joining. I'm so excited. We are starting Endless Ocean 2, Blue World. I know. It's wonderful. We've been waiting for this. We're here. Oh my goodness. Okay. Let's get started in our new journey in Blue World. Endless Ocean 1 was so good. I've got high hopes. You all have told me that this game expands on everything the previous did, but in a much better way, and I'm looking forward to seeing how it changes. Beautiful. Whales already? What? Whales already. Ooh, it's breaching. I would love one day to see a breaching whale. I feel like that would be the highlight of my life. Well, not... I've done other things, but I feel like that would be a highlight of my life. Look how big that one is. Looks like some blues and sperm whales migrating together. It looks interesting. Okay. Satoru Iwata, may he rest in paradise. Incredible. I've never seen so many in one place. It's like every whale in the ocean is here. So, your intuition was right on. I believed you, but this? It's amazing. Oh my goodness, look at that wetsuit. That is something. That's something. For so many whales to have gathered there, really must have been something here. Well, we won't know what it is until we start looking. You're already ready to dive in, aren't you? I can see it in your eyes. You really want to dive with all of these whales around? It could be dangerous. I'm just that kind of gal. So your character will be female, of course. Yes. Well, you're one brave gal, that's for sure. Your courage has saved us countless times. And this time is no different. We have to complete faith in you, or we have complete faith in you. But you should be careful. We don't know what's down there. We'll monitor you from the boat for now. So stay in contact with us, okay? Okay, let's go. Ooh, look at it. One day. Just a hungry whale. Just a hungry whale. Nom nom. Oh my gosh, what an experience to have, like, swimming with so many. We're diving more so, but we've got sperms and blues and humpbacks, like, incredible. Oh, I thought the rock behind was a whale. I was about to be fully in shock. Can you hear me? This is Jean-Eric. I'm monitoring your position, and I'll be directing you from the surface. First, turn facing west. Look at your compass to see which way you are facing. Right now, you're facing north. To face west, you'll need to turn to the left. I hear dolphin chirping. Point the Wii remote at the screen and move your cursor in any direction to turn to your character to that direction. Ta-da! Can you see an area in front of you where there's a hole in the cliff? Our survey data strongly suggests that there's something through there. Maybe dolphins? I see dolphins. Would you mind swimming over there and letting us know what you find? All the little dolphino chirps. Echoing terrace. It seems that you can pass through the back of the cave. Perhaps inside we'll find undiscovered path or truth behind the ancient legend. Ooh, another ancient legend. I wonder if they're searching for the same one or if it's a new legend. Keep moving forward and let us know what you see. Hold down B and swim through the cave. We've got it. What is through here? Ooh, some schools of fishies. Oh, wow. It's beautiful. What is this place? Could this really be it? Endless ocean, blue world. So excited. It all started on that fateful day in the South Pacific Ocean. Penguins. Oh! Oh, the callback. Bellagio Commonwealth, South Pacific. The Song of Dragons? You told me you were researching folklore in college, didn't you? Well, there's definitely a mention of that legend here in the Bellagio. The Song of Dragons brings misfortune, or some to such superstition. It's an odd thing to be interested in. Especially to have taken time out of your studies to pursue it here. While working for me at L&L Diving Service, well, at the very least this job will take you on to oceans across the globe. Of course, while you're researching, I'll expect you to do your share of guided tours and photography. But I'm getting ahead of myself. All of that, and what is your name again? Name is Siren. Sai. Come on. Ren. Siren. I don't need a space. Whoop. Is this name okay? Yes. As I've gotten older, it's become harder to remember people's names, you know? I remember faces, though, and I think your face is that of a person with great resolve. How would you describe your appearance? Fair. With fine features? Sure. Excellent. It's always interesting to hear how people see themselves. But we don't put much stock in that, in the way that people look around here. In this line of work, skill is more important than what's on the surface. That reminds me, there was no photo attached to your application. Maybe it fell off? Well, it doesn't matter. We're nearly there, so take a new photo before we arrive. I need one for your file. Are you ready? Say, squid! That's cute. Okay. Let's try that again. Let's take another crack at it. I guess it doesn't. That's fine. This is fine. Ooh. Nice shot. I'm curious if they'll change how you, the character creation and Luminous. I hope so. Because this is very limited. Now let me introduce myself properly. My name is Jean-Eric Louvier. I hear it's a dream of yours to work with me. In my younger days, I could understand somebody saying that, but this old man? It's been a long time since I've made a name for myself as a marine adventurer. A long time since I've really done anything. I dove too deep one too many times, and I suffered badly from decompression sickness. That is awful. That is truly an awful disease. The bends, we call it. It's left me with a serious metal condition, and I can never dive again. For those of you who may have dove in before, this is something that can critically change your life, especially if you love to dive and aren't diving safely. Even if you're a novice diver and, like, say you were traveling, right? There is a very strong rule that you don't dive or before or after 48 hours from coming out of an airplane. So if you're going on an airplane and you're wanting to dive, do it at least 2 days before you leave, because you need to decompress. Your body needs to decompress naturally before going so high in the altitude. It's very, very important. I'm just an old man abandoned by the sea. Aww. I have no time for things like your Song of Dragons. But we are shorthanded here, so anyone willing to work is more than welcome. Sorry I'm late. Oh, that's so funny, her name. You're just in time, Oceana. Oh, you must be the new job applicant. Let me introduce myself, my granddaughter, Oceana Louvier. Of course it's his granddaughter. Of course she's named Oceana. She is my pride and joy. Aww. And right now, she's the only diver at L&L Diving Service. Hey, what's up? Like my grandpa said, I'm Oceana. Nice to meet you. Believe it or not, I'm a seasoned pro with my years of diving experience. And I hear that you've done a little diving before yourself. Let's see what you can do. This dive will be your entrance examination for L&L Diving Service. Follow Oceana's instructions and see how well you can move around underwater. As soon as you're ready, we'll start the dive. Okay, select a spot. Sure. It's Hanma Atoll, depth 13 feet. The height of this area is its vast array of bright tropical fish and coral reef formations. Large fish can be found here at night. Ooh, okay. It's a nice little tidbit. Oh, look at our friends. The Gautama Atoll, Pelagio Commonwealth, South Pacific. Awesome. No trouble maintaining neutral buoyancy, and your posture looks good. Looks like you have more than a little diving experience. Let's get started. I'll introduce you to the Gautama Atoll. This area is called the Atoll Gate. It's a small coral reef on the northwest of Gautama Atoll. Smaller sea creatures make up most of marine life here. Let's see how well you do with interacting with them. Point at a creature, then press A to focus. All right. Perfect, you focused on a particular fish. Focusing on an animal lets you access detailed information about it. It also makes it easier to interact. The best way to get close to animals is feeding them, of course. Try equipping the food tool. Press down. Food. When your glove appears, press and hold the A and hold out some food. Then let go of A to release it. Oh, cool. You can touch the animals too. Shake the Wii remote and touch the creature you're focused on. Normally, you shouldn't touch and or interfere with animals in the wild, but here there are some that love to be touched. Look at them. I think they like you. I think they like the food. Let's be honest here. Interacting with animals like this helps you learn more about them. This valuable information will make it easier for your work here. There are lots of small fish living amongst the coral rocky reefs. If you find a place where you think they might be hiding, press A and zoom in. Look around and practice your techniques a little more. Once you've gotten to know this area, we'll leave the gate, the atoll gate, and go exploring. Oh. Oh. That was a little disorienting. Visually, it's quite good. It's much better than, obviously, the former, but... Oh, oh, come here. Flame angel. These things, while very beautiful, not good for coral in like aquarium habitats. They like to munch on coral. The nice thing about them in the wild is that when they munch on the coral, they're helping the coral to kind of stay maintained instead of either overgrowing one another, because what a lot of people don't know is a lot of coral, they will sting each other to maintain their own territory, so to speak. So they'll sting each other and end up usually killing one another to maintain territory. Angelfish help with the natural balance of keeping them maintained. Pyramid butterfly fish. Hello again, friend. Nice to see you in EO2. Yeah, it's much easier in this game to become familiar with. Oh, zoom mode. It's a juvenile emperor angel. Yeah, got it. They're very distinct. Once you see a fish like this, there's no mistaking it. It's an emperor angel fish, a juvenile emperor angel. Because they do look completely different when they're bigger and when they grow. Parrotfish. Yep. Bower's parrotfish. Let's see if we can feed you. I wonder if we can pet. Is this... Am I... I feel like I'm not doing it properly. Got food? Interesting. Okay. Let's see what... Woo! This little area over here has for us. Ooh, yes, the batfish. Remember when I was telling you about the batfish in EO1? So in the last Endless Ocean? If I'm correct, these are juvenile batfish. This is what they look like, and I had mentioned they have like this bright orange essentially outline around them. And when they grow, they completely lose that and look much differently. A lot like the Emperor Angels. Dusky batfish. Yes, juveniles. Got it. That's so cool. Yeah, they lose that orange line when they grow, and then they have stripes instead and a black outline. It's very, very neat to see how they change throughout their maturity. Ooh, some gobbies. Yellow clown goby. Oops. And a five-lined coral goby. Five lines are up on the head. Gobies are such interesting little creatures. They're so funny to watch. The one I have in my aquarium is a sand sifting goby. And he will bite at the sand, and then the sand will go through his gills. So he's sifting through the detritus for food. And it's so interesting to watch. What else? Oh, we gotta see the tangs, the yellow sailfin tangs. These little guys are awesome for picking out parasites that live in coral. Parasites or even aptasia, which can be harmful in a reef aquarium, but again, totally natural in the wild as well. Crescent tail big eye. Pretty. Kind of reminds me of a goldfish. We've got the Moorish idol. I think we got most of the ones swimming around. I wonder if what else we can find in the coral. This one definitely feels more fluid, but I think it's just because I have more experience now since playing the first one. Okay. Can we still open the map? Oh, I see something. What is it? Oh, two somethings, actually. Now we're going to move to explore the calm waters of the Katama Atoll. It's a marine playground with lots of fish. I'm sure you will just love it. I see a ray. Love the sea pancakes. What is it? Look at that! A whale calf. It is so rare to see one. We might never get a chance to see one again. Let's get closer. Ooh, I don't know about this, but it is so cute. It's so little. Oh, aw, it's smiling. It's a humpback whale calf. Judging by how small it could be only a month or so old. Strange that it's not swimming with its mother. I wonder if they got separated. This is not a good situation. Let's find the mother. Great idea. She must be somewhere near the Katama Atoll. We have to find the mother. If that humpback whale's calf mother is still somewhere in the Katama Atoll, where would she go? Maybe the spring garden area? Oh, right. You don't know where that is yet. It's directly south of here. I've marked it on your map. Let's head for the spring garden right away. Oh, it is, like, quite far. The map contains only a rough outline of the coast at first, but as you dive through different areas, the details will be filled in. You'll also be rewarded for filling in your maps. Ooh, okay. So it looks like we need to go this way. Ooh. Purple Queen Antheus? I'm pretty sure those are Queen Antheuses. They're really pretty in real life. They're that vibrant purple. Ooh, some sharks. Sawfish shark. And a turtle! Ooh, a palette. Oh man. I'm struggling. Let's get the sawfish shark. Sawtooth shark. Dwarf sawfish. What is this? Oh, there's the sailfin tanks. Bowmouth guitarfish. Those are interesting. I wonder if it's a subspecies of shark. Gotta get the sailfins. Is it gonna call it a Destrardini? Nope, just sailfin. Specific naming for this one is Destrardini tang, and it is technically a sailfin because of the long dorsal fin. Green sea turtle. I really hope they expand with a different species of turtles. I don't know if they'll be in this one, but I would love to see like hawksbill, leatherbacks, Kemp's Ridley, olive Ridley, greens, and there's one more. I can't think of it at the top of my head, but it'd be cool to see all of, there's only 7 major subspecies, so it's not a lot in the grand scheme of things, you know? All right. Oops. Let's see if we can find... Oh, we're close. I love how the map is actually color coordinated as opposed to how it was in the last game. That's really nice. Oh, we must have found her. There she is. Yay. Gotta reunite the mama and her calf. In a very real world, we would likely be hearing them using sonar to find one another. Well, not really sonar, but echolocation. Echolocation to find one another. There she is, the mother humpback whale. They usually dive in deeper areas farther out in the open sea. But at this time of year, when they're giving birth and raising their young, they come to a warm, shallow waters of the Gautama Atoll. All right, let's hope the calf recognizes its mother. Oh, it's so cute. There is the echolocation. I'm so glad we got them together again. Hey, look out. Oh, how cute. That's a cute, but still a very big baby. How rude. Oh no. Oh no, my pendant. Interesting. Hey, did you hear something coming from that pendant? You heard it too, didn't you? Whoa. What was that sound? Look out! She's going to ram us. Get out of the way. Shake, 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 shake. Why is it not working? Shake the Wii remote. Thank God. Let me tell you, I know this seems quick for y'all, but this took me an hour and a half to figure out how to fix the controls. And I'm exhausted. I'm exhausted. Okay, let's keep moving on. What on earth was that about? That sound coming from that pendant. Then the whale went crazy. Hey, where did that whale go? It looks like she settled down, probably because her calf is reunited with her. They say whales are even closer to their young than other sea creatures. Look! Look! Aw, the mother is feeding her calf. What's that? You think it looks strange? Whales are mammals too, don't forget. This is how they nurse their young. It's so great to see them back together. Now to get my pendant back. That's strange. I know I dropped it over here. Where did it go? Oh no, look over there. It got caught on the whale's snout and all that chaos. What am I going to do? That's a memento for my mother. You can grab onto large sea creatures that just focus on them and select the icon on the lower screen. Okay. Interesting. Oh, wow. New item, the sea pendant. It's a cylindrical pendant made from a blue stone. It has the words, "The Road to Truth," engraved in small letters. Oh, thank you so much. You got my pendant back. Okay, let's head back to the boat. Grandpa's probably worried about us. To the boat. Yes. Oh my gosh. Up we go. Well, how was it? You were gone a long time. I was beginning to worry. What? You were nearly hit by a humpback whale. Yeah, it happened when I dropped my pendant. It made this strange sound, and the whale went crazy. I've never seen anything like it, and I'm still not sure what happened. I see. So that's why you took so long to return. Well, there are many mysteries surrounding that thing. Matthias and I originally recovered that pendant from the bottom of the sea. Matthias Louvier was my son, and Oceana's father. He died 15 years ago. What's up? Is something bothering you? You think the sound from the pendant was something to do with the Song of Dragons? You seem to know an awful lot about this. I think it was nothing more than water rushing through the pendant and making some weird sound. But could something like that actually happen by accident? The Song of Dragons brings misfortune. That's what the legend says. Maybe that's why the humpback got angry. Is there something special about the two pendants that Mom and Dad left me? Grandpa, about the other pendant. It's at the bottom of the deep hole, right? The one you lost when you were just a child? Yes, that is where you dropped it. I've got to find it. I have to go after it. You lost that years ago, Oceana. You'll never find it now. Besides, that area is very dangerous. I won't let you dive there anyway. But just forget about these worthless superstitions. On a more important note, what was our new recruit? Any good? Absolutely. Even I was impressed. You should have been there to see it, Grandpa. I've never seen anyone with such quick reflexes underwater. Well, you certainly seem to have made an impression on Oceana. That's good enough for me. Consider yourself a member of L&L Diving Service. Congratulations. I'm looking forward to many more dives together. It's getting late. We must make our way back to the island. Yes, can finally save. The next day. Siren, wake up! Sorry to wake you so early. I had no choice but to bring you along. It's Oceana. She ignored what I said and went off to the deep hole. As you heard yesterday, that's where the other pendant sank. The one that goes with the pendant that you helped Oceana retrieve yesterday. Matthias gave those pendants to his wife and daughter before he died. Unfortunately, it wasn't long after that that Oceana's mother passed away and left the pendant to Oceana. But Oceana dropped her own pendant in the sea, and it was lost. The terrain is in this area is very difficult. But the real dangers are aggressive tiger sharks that sometimes hunt here. I'm worried about Oceana. Please, you must bring her back to safety. Okay, we're here. Here's the corridor leading to the deep hole, just south of here. You can't see it at first glance, but it is a narrow, shallow channel with a forest kelp growing around it. The dense kelp makes it inaccessible by boat. There is no choice but to start your dive from here. Oceana must have done the same thing on her personal watercraft. It's parked just over there. As I mentioned, I have a medical condition and it won't allow me to dive. I know you met just yesterday, but I really need your help. You have the necessary skills, and I know you can do this. Please, find Oceana. I'm counting on you. Thank you. I knew I could rely on you. Pulsar? Okay. This device is called a pulsar. Take it with you. It looks like a gun, but it's actually an electromagnetic device primarily used to heal marine creatures. But you can use it to pacify them as well.